Alberto Soto with Siemens PLM Software. Today I will present the Battery Datasheet Import Tool, a standard feature of LMS Imagine Lab AmSim. When sizing a battery for a specific application, we usually do not have access to costly measurement data. An alternative is to use the supplier-provided datasheet in order to generate a quasi-static model. This can easily be done by using the Battery Datasheet Import Tool. I start by loading the Battery Datasheet Import Tool methodology demo. Here we will find a battery model connected to a virtual test bench. We will compare the results to measurement data from an actual test bench. To launch the tool, we click on the battery model and launch the Battery Datasheet Import Tool. Here we can define a project name, battery nominal capacity, and the characterization type. You can do this either by loading discharge curves in function of temperature, or OCV and discharge curves. For now, we will keep it simple and just load several discharge curves. We start by choosing the image we want to load. We have to define a scaling for that image. So we zoom in on the image, select a first point to define the x-axis. We select two points along that axis, for example, 0 and 40. And then again, two points along the y-axis, 2.6 and 4. Now our image has been scaled. Then we select the color we want to acquire and click the Acquire button. Now we must define what type of curve we are importing. First, we must define the curve type, in this case, discharge, the name of the curve, in this case, I call it first, the axis type, in this case, capacity is already correct, the C rate, which as we can see in the legend is 0.33, and the temperature, in this case, 23 degrees. Our curve is automatically acquired, but as we can see here, some legend points have also been taken. We remove those points, and then, in order to have a clean curve, we do a reinterpolation. That way we have evenly spaced breakpoints. Now we do the same thing for the next curve at 1C. Again, we give it a name, set the C rate and the temperature. Again, we remove unnecessary points and reinterpolate. And finally, we do it for the third curve. So we call it third, set the C rate, temperature. In this case, the legend was not captured, so we simply reinterpolate. Now that we have our three curves, we can add them to the model calibration data list. We simply drag and drop them into the list. As we can see, the list has now turned green. This means we are ready to proceed. Also, the model calibration tab has now become enabled. And so we can launch our identification. We see that our three curves are shown here, the calculated OCV shown here, and the resistance value is shown here. If we are content with our results, we can move on to the statistics tab. Here we can evaluate how our model is working. We are comparing the crosses, which represent the acquired curves, with the lines, which represent the simulated results. As we can see, they match pretty well. Other than visually, we can also compare average and maximum values, or we can visualize the error, either absolute error or simply the error. We can also visualize the error samples, that is to say, where our error is mostly located. As we can see here, it is centered around zero, which is pretty good. We click OK, and the parameters are now been sent to our battery model. The only thing left is to run a simulation. We launch our simulation, and so now we will compare measurement data to our simulation results. As we can see here, the input to the system is a current profile. The current profile is made out of electric vehicle and hybrid electric vehicle cycles. So we can compare the input voltage for validation. We see the results are pretty good. If we zoom in to an electric vehicle cycle, we see that the overall results are good and that we match the quasi-static characteristics pretty well. Same thing for the hybrid electric vehicle. And last but not least, we can also compare temperature. And even though we have a very simple thermal model, we see that the results match pretty well. That is all for now. Thank you for watching, and please visit our website.